Well, no rush for the Philippine Central Bank to cut rates. That's according to Ruben Paracueles, chief ASEAN economist at Nomura. He cites an easing inflation and a resilient domestic economy for his forecast. Paracueles believes the BSP may only begin its policy tightening cycle by August. He sees the central bank cutting rates by a total of 100 basis points this year, another 50 in 2025.
I think for the next several months, they will be on hold their own forecast while they've reduced the CPI inflation average for this year lower. But their trajectory is still the same in the sense that they're still looking at a potential reacceleration by second quarter, which could again, breach the top end of the 2-4% target, which I very much share. The way Governor Eli has been sort of thinking about these risks is, I think he'd rather be patient in the cutting cycle than make the mistake of cutting too early.
The BSP kept key rates unchanged at a near 17-year high of 6.5% Thursday, calling it a prudent move as inflation risks linger. But it did lower the inflation outlook for the year to 3.9% within government's 2-4% target range. The consortium led by San Miguel Corporation wins the bidding for the rehabilitation of Manila's main gateway, Naiya. The Transportation Department announced today it has awarded the 170 billion peso project to the Ramon Ang-led company. San Miguel offered the highest bid of a whopping 82% revenue share to the government. It outbid India's GMR and the consortium made up by Ayala Aboitiz and Agongkongway families. San Miguel now has the mammoth task of giving Naiya, which is listed among the worst airports in Asia, a much-needed facelift and a capacity boost. This is the second airport project in San Miguel's portfolio. It is also bidding a new gateway in Bulacan province. The government aims to sign the concession deal with the consortium by mid-March. Oil prices expected to increase next week after a slight rollback before Valentine's Day. According to estimates from the Philippine Energy Department, motorists would have to pay at least a peso and 30 centavos more for a liter of gasoline, while diesel could go up by at least 1 peso and 10 centavos, and kerosene by as much as a peso and 60 centavos. The DOE points to the intensification of the Middle East conflict, disruption of shipping in the Red Sea, and a surge in the stockpile of U.S. crude for the increase. The Philippine Senate is set to approve a bill pushing for an across-the-board wage hike, but their House counterparts aren't sure if Filipinos will indeed benefit from the measure. Archie Cruz tells us more.
This early, the House of Representatives is already studying the Senate's proposal for a 100 peso legislated wage hike for workers. This House leader explains they do not want to raise false hopes because aside from the amount being too low, small and medium-sized businesses may not be able to afford it. It's a sentiment first bared by the top economists of the House last Monday.
The marching orders of the Speaker and the leaders of the House, gawin ang lahat para maibsan ang hirap ng buhay ng bawat pamilyang Pilipino. Pero kakibat doon, yung gagawin mo ang totoong mangyayari, hindi yung paasa lang. Ang takot natin doon, baka yung 10 empleyado ay maging 7 na lang. No? So yun yung medyo dapat natin i-balance.
Kaya lang kasing iwalayin yung mga malalaking kumpanya, pwede sana yun eh. Kaso tatawanan yan SMEs eh, mamamatay lahat yun eh. Kasi hindi nila kakayanin eh. Hindi nila talaga kakayanin. Kumbaga, 99% ng lahat ng enterprise natin, SMEs.
A business leader raises a similar concern.
Lalo na mga yung micro, hirap-hirap na magbito sweldo nila. Even na tataas mo ng 25% yung sweldo. Hindi kaya. Yun namang mga malalaki eh. Hindi mo naman kailangan sabihin pa yan eh. Mahigit pa rin ang binibigay ng sweldo ng mga yon.
Senate leaders, however, believe this is a step in the right direction.
The business sector has enough buffer to absorb the cost. Yeah. It's not the question if will they make money. Yes, they will still continue to make money, but it's how much money they will make. So we have to also moderate the greed when it comes to to large corporations. The micro, small, medium enterprises will not be that affected. Under the CREATE law, the taxes, corporate income taxes of micro, small, and medium enterprises was brought down to 20%. 20%. Yeah. Yeah. So from 33% to 20%, they have a 13% tax cut from their income tax. Kaya naman nila yun.
The Senate is expected to approve the proposed bill on third and final reading on Monday with the hope that the lower house will immediately tackle the measure. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Internet services in the Philippines getting a boost. President Marcos on Thursday led the activation of the Philippine Domestic Submarine Cable Network. Now, this aims to bring fiber connectivity to unserved and underserved areas in the country. Spanning approximately 2,500 kilometers, the project connects Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao with touch points in 21 provinces. Marcos says the new undersea fiber cable network is a game changer, which could be the long-term solution to the country's internet connectivity issues. In a study last year, the Philippines ran 86th out of 220 countries in terms of internet speed.
Because of this connection, we now find a long-term solution that delivers high connectivity and high-speed internet for our people and facilitates the realization of the Bagong Pilipinas that we envision for our country. With this project, we will be able to better position our country as an even more attractive destination for technology-centric businesses such as hyperscale data centers and AI computing. With the completion of the PDSCN, let me express our excitement and our optimism as we zoom in on faster fiber internet speeds for Filipinos.
Ayala Malls has set aside 13 billion pesos to give four of its flagship malls in the Philippines a makeover. But that's not all. As the firm's officials say, more luxury brands are coming into the country as the renovations progress. Jackie Pascual reports.
Ayala Malls is spending 13 billion pesos to renovate four of its major malls in Metro Manila and Cebu as part of efforts to improve the mall experience of Filipinos. This amid the rise of online shopping and new technologies. Greenbelt and Glorieta in Makati, Trinoma in Quezon City, and Ayala Center Cebu will undergo what they call reinvention to improve the overall design, expand green spaces, and enhance access for commuters and motorists.
This is the first time in our history that we will embark on renovating at least four of our major flagship malls at once. So almost 400,000 square meters in gross leasable area, significant investment.
We're looking at everything from our websites, our customer loyalty app, car parking, wayfinding. The more we can do to encourage them to dwell with us longer, and that has a positive, sustainable benefit for our tenants as well.
They will also improve its digital platform and add QR codes around the mall after learning that customers tend to get lost in their malls.
We've heard a lot from customers and experienced ourselves the challenge of getting through some of our bigger malls. Within the mall, just finding your way through the mall.
Okay. Getting lost in the
maze. Getting lost in the mall.
Okay. So that's a 70s design, by the way.
I think our app, the Ayala Malls Zing app, has done a lot to help that.
A traffic impact study is also in the works as they plan to close off some roads in Glorieta and integrate the two small parks nearby into the mall.
We've got to understand how that flows, how the urban traffic control works. You can have had the best day in the world, but if you then spend 3 hours waiting to pay your 20 pesos to get out, it completely ruins the impacts.
He adds they may put up a Palawan cherry orchard garden in one of the malls to have a feel of Japan's cherry blossoms. This will further enhance the shopping experience as more luxury brands are expected to set up shop in the Philippines.
With Greenbelt 3 and 4 renovations, we saw an increase in demand from what we call heritage luxury brands. So these are the likes of Louis Vuitton, Dior, Fendi, Loewe. Most of them that we're planning for don't exist in the country today.
Officials say the malls will not be closed during the renovation as it will be done in stages, which is expected to be completed between 2026 and 2028. Other Ayala malls and Seda hotels will also undergo minor renovations. It also expects to welcome back Mandarin Oriental in about 2 years. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.